trying to counter, wasn't the aggressor, you know, wasn't the boxer. You know, he switched. I was doing everything, boxing, aggressing, taking chances. This man was just sitting back, taking, you know, he got a good sneaky left hand. Everybody knows Tarver's left hand built his career, you know, so the power is the last thing that goes. So that was basically it, you know. Outside of that, I know I out jabbed him. I'm not even looking at CompuBox numbers or none of that. I know I outworked him. You know, I know I outdid him. It's just one of them things, you know. I'm down on the fact that it could have been, you know, the way it went, you know, that it wasn't as obvious as I wanted it to be. You know, that's why I'm a little down. I don't think he beat me, no doubt, but I'm just down on, you know, because we set out to do something in training camp and it didn't happen, you know. So, but we adjusted to those things, landed good shots, put pressure on them, kept the body work going. I don't, you know, it is what it is.
Did he ever hurt you? Because he wasn't very active.
He wasn't active, but he did buzz me. He caught me a couple times, but he buzzed me a couple times. I can't lie. You know, boom, I wobble, but my recovery time is immaculate, you know. So, I mean, y'all know me. I get hit, get down, get up. He buzzed me. I think that discouraged him, you know, because he's used to putting guys down with that left hand. And it buzzed me, and he tried to come get me, and I was right there. Boop, 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 boop. I ain't going nowhere, you know. So, back to work, you know, hands up, jabbing, working the body, running the punches. But I buzzed him a couple. The first thing he said to me after the fight, before the decision was rendered, was, you know you didn't hurt me, you know? And I'm like, I know I hurt you, you know I hurt you, but he's a competitive guy, I'm a competitive guy. We still have words in the ring, you know? So after the fight, before the decision, and...
I saw you interact. I'm like, what is he saying?
Well, you know, because he's such a, excuse my English, he's a bullshitter, you know? He's a bullshitter. And, you know, he's running around, yeah, I won, I know I won. And I'm like, no, you didn't, bro. You know you didn't win. No, Steve, I won that. I hurt you. I mean, you didn't hurt me. I'm like, dude, you know I hurt you. Everybody knows I hurt you. You hurt me, too. Like, you know, what the freak? You know, so, you know, he's got a left hand that, you know, a lot of people wish they had. But we stood up to it. Now, after the fight, when the decision was rendered, it was a draw. He was all smiles. I'm not happy with a draw at all. That's why I'm a little down on myself, not on anything else. I'm just down. I don't like a draw. I want to win. You know, he was very happy with a draw. You know, so
let me ask you this.
Yeah.
After the rematch with Adamek, after the Glasgow fight. When it went to the decision, after the second scorecard, when it's 1-1, at that point, were you thinking, oh man, this is not going to be good again?
No, actually, this fight, I felt we did, you know, I felt we won it. So when they read the last one, I'm like, okay. Then I was like, oh, when they read that, was it 114? I was like, wow, you know, the draw. I'm just like, it doesn't even, not that it doesn't faze me, it just makes me feel like I didn't do my job enough to show these judges that I won. You know, that's the only thing it does to me. That's why I'm a little angry. I felt good. We did great in camp, great in sparring. Tony Thompson came, sparred with me. Bigfoot, you know, Southpaws we have. And I felt great. But when you get in a fight, things change, and you just got to put in different work.
Where does this leave you, man? Because I know both of you guys came in saying, you know, this, the winner of this fight just, you know, positions himself for something. Where does this leave you?
I mean, me personally, right now, I'm ready to go back to the drawing board and put in work and just see where we at. I got to look at the tape, see what we did, see what I did that didn't correlate with the plan we wanted. But other than that, I still feel good about the performance, about the push, about when things change from what you set out to do, we'll still adapt and evolve and do things different. So I felt like this is good stuff. It's just, we just didn't get the nod. You know, close or not, a win is a win. But I wanted to win by a larger margin.
Steve, you were a two-time cruiserweight champion.
Yeah.
You're about the skinniest heavyweight there is. I mean, you know, 204, you join Nutrisystem and do, you know, lose 5 pounds a week back to cruiserweight. But you also know that cruiserweight champions usually don't make as much as heavyweight contenders. I mean, you know, your thoughts on that? I know why you did it for you know, because money is that heavyweight.
That's not even the truth. You know, like those Adam McFury and Mansoor fights, there wasn't no money. You know, being with, you know, PBC, you know, this was a big purse for me, biggest purse I had. But, you know, you still got to build up to that, you know, to get that money. But I just like the challenge, you know? I like to fight. I like to go in where they're saying, you can't win. You're not supposed to win. This dude's bigger than you. That's why he's going to beat you. You know, that drives me in camp. So, you know, I did the cruiserweight thing already. I beat the WBO champion. Well, he's not champ anymore. He got KO'd. You know, I beat the WBA champion, who was Guillermo Jones at the time. And them dudes didn't want to unify with me. I left the cruiserweight. I did it already. I'm here in heavyweight.
It's a little frustrating, you know, when the guy who has the WBC title, which is Deontay Wilder, Eric Molina, and now some French guy nobody ever heard of. I mean, you know, like you got to believe. I mean, obviously, you're not going to be fighting on September 26th, but, you know.
No. I mean, I don't think that was the plan anyway, but, you know, anything can happen. It's boxing, you know what I'm saying? My next fight could be a first round, one punch knockout win for me, you know, so we'll see. I'm just, these type of things drive me and make me, you know, puts a fire in me, man, that's already compounding the fire that's already there, so, you know.
So what do you do, man?